रोल नंबर 15 15 रोल नंबर 15 एंड 20 पृथ्वीराज बाबर बाबर पृथ्वीराज इज इट ऑडिबल आई एम आस्किंग टू यू ओनली हर्षवर्धन शिंदे सॉरी मुरडे रोल नंबर 20 वॉइस इज ऑडिबल
यस सर
रोल नंबर 15 एंड 20 रिप्लाई फास्ट बोथ हैव नॉट जॉइंड फॉर द ऑडियो Okay, in the last class, we have discussed about the problems on Kelvin double bridge. Actually, we have discussed numericals on the full derivation of the Kelvin double bridge. We have already discussed it, and one problem we have solved. I think this problem is solved. Yes. Someone had changed the setting, I think. इसका पहले कौन लिया था क्लास कौन सा क्लास हुआ इसके पहले
सर अपेस टेस्ट था
Leave it. Okay. So this problem yesterday class we have already discussed this, and today we are going to take one more problem on Kelvin double bridge only. Okay. Take a problem. A Kelvin double bridge is balanced with the following constant. Is balanced with following constants. The outer ratio arms 100 and 1000 ohms. Outer ratio arms are 100 and 1000 ohms. Inner ratio arms are 99.92. And 1000.6 ohms. The link resistance is 0.1 ohm. The link resistance is 0.1 ohm. Standard resistance is 3.77 milliohms. Standard resistance is 3.77 milliohms. Find the unknown resistance. So you already know the formula for the Kelvin double bridge. This is capital outer. Outer ratio is nothing but capital P, capital Q. Inner ratio is means small p, small q. And the link resistance is small r. Standard resistance means yes, the unknown resistance means R. You have to calculate here. So all of you do the calculation and tell the answer to me. I will wait for your response. You have to calculate the capital R. You have to calculate. Randomly, I will ask the questions. I will take names. You have to give the reply. Otherwise, I will put absent for the today class. Whatever it may be, correct or wrong, we have to give the reply. Roger, I'm asking you people only, don't waste the time. All of you take the pen and paper, solve it. Everybody have to solve this problem. Screen is visible or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Pura answer solution dikh rahe hai kya? Sirf only ye dikh rahe.
Only equation.
Only equation. Only equation, na? Okay, very good. Tell the answer first then. All of you have the calculators? Mobile hai sir, calculator kyun chahiye aise bol rahe hain? Over, anybody solved? If anybody solves, it's okay. Don't waste the time, solve it. Yesterday already we have solved one problem. Same problem is there, only values are changed here now. Sirf value change hai na, baki thing to same hai. Watch. Anyone can you tell the answer? Internet connection problem hai, ek minute. Ha. Yes, over. हो गए क्या नहीं?
सर आंसर वो हमें निकलना है कि मिलियो हमें
क्या बोल रहे, कौन सा भी ये रहने दो, मिलियो और होम्स, कौन सा भी, एनी एज पर योर इंटरेस्ट कौन सा भी बोल सकते हैं आंसर. वक्त हो गए क्या नहीं वो बोलो पहला. रूल नंबर 16, रूल नंबर 11, अभी आया तो कैसे चल रहे? व्हाट इज द टाइम नाउ? ज्वाइनिंग, यू पीपल आर ज्वाइनिंग नाउ. Anyone else? Have you solved the problem? तो इतना टाइम चाहिए क्या सॉल्व करने के लिए? हाउ मच टाइम यू आर टेकिंग? ये इंटरनेट कनेक्शन थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम है इधर. Yes. What is the answer? See, all of you. So first you have to write the given data. Given data you have to write. The outer arm ratio is nothing but capital P, small capital Q, this one. Inner arm ratio is nothing but small P, small Q. And link resistance means small R you have to write down. So all the given data I will write here. So these 100,000 ohms are outer ratios. 99.92 and 1,000.6 is the inner ratios. The link resistances are 0.1 ohm and the standard resistance is 3.77 milli ohms is there. So milli is nothing but 10 to the power of minus 3 we have to do. So 0.00377 we can write this one ohms here now. And R you have to calculate. We know the formula. We know the formula, that is R equal to P by QES plus QR divided by P plus Q plus R into P by Q minus P by Q here. See, this P is given value. You know this value? Capital P malum hai?
100 ohm.
Screen not see. Screen visible नहीं क्या?
Yes.
100 ohm.
100 ohm नहीं नहीं कोई तो एक message किया है उसके लिए पूछो. 100 ohm. क्यों?
1000
ohm. 1000 yes.
3.77 milli ohm.
0.00377 you can write down. Plus this Q.
This 1000.6.
This one R 0.1. So substitute these all values. These all are given directly. R we have to calculate here now. Substituting this one, we'll get all the values I have substituted here now.
0.388
milli. How much?
0.388 milli ohm.
388 milli ohm. Correct answer. 0.388 or 89 both are same, only 3888 you will get that one. Three digits will consider that. 0.389 or 88 milli ohm is the correct answer. How many of you got the answer? Is it going to answer? Tell your roll numbers.
Yes, sir.
Roll number 5.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
2.
Yes, sir.
29. Okay.
Very yes, good. Sir.
Okay, 41. Very good. So out of 44 students, only that four members, they have told the correct answers. So other people, you have to involve. See the subject, don't think this one is easy. Then the examination, it will create a problem for you people. Okay. So it completes the DC bridge just now. So problems we have solved. Next I will go. See, it has some limitations also. This bridge also, it has some limitations because the sensitive element, whatever we are using, the galvanometer, that is for the balance condition only. It is used for detecting the balance condition here. Okay, that is very sensitive. So high current measurement should be very sensitivity. It should have a good sensitivity here now. See, it is used for the Kelvin double bridge is used for the low resistance or higher resistance? The MCQ question was given in the ISC. Kelvin double bridge circuit is used for low measurement or high measurement?
Low measurement.
So, sorry, low resistance. Low measurement, what are the low resistance measurement? Okay. So, low resistance means the current should be high or low?
High.
For that reason only, the high measurement current is required. High current measurement is required for obtaining the good sensitivity here now. Okay. With these limitations, you have to note this one for obtaining the appropriate result. It is very essential that the ratio of the arms must be equal. If the ratio of the arms is equal, then we can say that one, it is equal to the Kelvin double, sorry, Wilson bridge equation, same equation we can use for this one. Okay, just a minute only. Okay, so the unequal arm ratio causes the error in the result here now. If the unequal arm ratios are there, then it will cause the error. So also the value of resistance R should be kept minimum for obtaining the exact result here now. The R value we should have to kept minimum because that is the connector resistance we are connecting between bridges here now. We have to keep that one minimum, then we will get the exact result of the Kelvin double bridge here now. So it completes the DC bridges. Next, we'll go for the AC bridges here now. The AC bridges use, AC bridge uses for the measurement of the, measuring the values of unknown resistance, inductance, capacitance. In the DC bridges, only resistance is key. But here, the combinations of resistance, inductance, capacitance circuit we are going to use from the AC bridge, it is possible to measure the resistance, inductance, capacitance. Those are which bridge circuit is going to measure the resistance, inductance, capacitance value. That bridge is known as AC bridge we are going to call here. So AC bridges are very convenient and give the accurate result of the measurement. You know, not only AC bridge, all the bridges, both the AC and DC bridges are very convenient. It will give the accurate results we are saying here now. In an AC bridge, each of the four arms, अभी bridge means क्या है बोल के मालूम हो गया आपको, bridge circuit मालूम हो गया, Wilson bridge आपने देखा है, we are going to consider Wilson bridge only. All P, Q, R, S are R1, R2, R3, R4 resistances are connected in the form of bridge, and in between we are going to connect one galvanometer. But in the AC bridge, what we will do? All four, whatever the R1, R2, R3, R4 are there, these are replaced by impedances Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. These are replaced by impedances we are going to call that one. See here, I will take here somewhere I can, I will draw this one here. See here, this is the R1 tana pahila, this one. 1, 2, 3, 4 here. This like this, the bridge was there. Here, R1 is, R1 of the Wilson bridge is replaced by Z1 here now. And R2 of the Wilson bridge is replaced by Z2. Is nothing but impedance we are going to call here now. And R3 is replaced by, R3 is replaced by
Z3.
And R4 is replaced by Z4 here. Z4, we are going to call that. So each of four arms, each of these four arms is an impedance here, no? And the battery is replaced by, here the battery was connected, it was replaced by AC source here, no? Instead of battery, we are giving the alternating current source we are providing here. Battery and the galvanometer is replaced by the detector here, no? We are going to call small detector, we are going to use here. The battery and the galvanometer of the Wheatstone bridge are replaced respectively by an AC source. Battery is replaced by AC source and the galvanometer is replaced by the detector sensitive to a small alternating potential here. Now, for the alternating AC potential difference, which sensitive detector hai, wo sensitive detector we are going to use here. Now. So the usefulness of AC bridge circuit is not restricted to the measurement of unknown impedances and associated parameters like inductance measure kar sakte, capacitance, storage factor, quality factor, dissipation factor, all the things we can measure from the AC bridges here. But you have to think that one, in the place of resistance, we are going to, all four arms are impedance here now. What do you mean by impedance? Anyone, can you tell me? Impedance means what? I'll use short introduction of impedance here now, then we'll go for the AC bridges. The bridge circuit will go there. In an electrical engineering example, I will tell you, what do you mean by resistance? Anyone, can you tell me?
Opposite
flow of current.
Opposite to the flow of current. So what do you mean by impedance? That is also opposite to the flow of current only. It is also opposite to the flow of current only, but it is the combination of resistance and reactance. Reactance here. Reactance is maybe inductive reactance or capacitive reactance. It is nothing but the impedance is the combination of resistance, inductance, and capacitance. Or resistance, inductance, or resistance, capacitance. Some may have. So instead of resistance, here combination of resistance, inductance, capacitance, that is called impedance we are going to call. It will also opposes the current only. It will also opposes the current only here now. See here, in electrical engineering, electrical impedance is the measure of the opposition that a circuit presents to a current here now. When a voltage AC is applied, current will start to flow that one. The impedance will start to oppose that one here. That is called impedance we are going to call it. The impedance extends the concept of resistance to alternating current AC circuits here now. It will extend the concept of resistance to the AC circuits here now. It possesses, it has both magnitude and angle here now. Phase we are going to call that. Magnitude and phase or angle here now. Angle also, it has 90 degree leading, lagging. So now, we have studied the first year. It may be 90 degree leading, lagging, and all the things we are going to study here now. See here. Suppose if a resistance, if the AC circuit for the fewer resistance, what is the current and voltage angle?
Both are in phase.
Both are in phase. Very good. The current, if the for the pure resistance circuit, both are in phase, we are going to call that one here. Both are in phase for the resistive circuit here. Now, here the current is there, means the voltage will be like this here. Now. Okay, this is V you consider, this is I here. Now. Next, if the for fewer inductive circuit, what will be the current?
Current lag the voltage by 90.
Current lag the voltage.
Here I will consider voltage here. Means current lags, means it was a downside or upside?
Downside.
Downside here now. So this is called lagging here now. I we are going to call that. If for the pure capacitive circuit, what will the current?
Lead the voltage.
Lead the voltage here now. This is the leading. Current is IA heavy. C See here, same thing we have written here. Now, a circuit where current lags 90 degree. Current lags the 90 degree of lag means voltage se piche 90 degree hai nahi hai. Straight line nahi hai. Straight line I will take that. It is 90 degree here. In respect of applied voltage, in a purely inductive circuit, for the L circuit here. Now, this is for C circuit. This is for the R circuit. So, current lags the voltage 90 degree for the pure inductive circuit. Current leads the voltage by 90 degree for the capacitive circuit. And current is in phase with the voltage for the resistive circuit here. Now, there is no phase difference here. Now, so for that reason only, it possesses, impedance possesses both magnitude and phase here. Now, we are going to call that one here. So, where a circuit where the current does not lag, nor lead in respect to the applied voltage in a purely resistive circuit, which is in phase, we are going to call it. Suppose when a DC circuit is driven with a DC circuit, DC circuit means what do you mean by impedance over there? In the DC circuit, is there impedance? Impedance equal to R only, we can write. Yes, for the DC circuit, we can say that one, Z equal to R. Z equal to R, that thing here. Now, we have written, when a circuit is driven with direct current, there is no distinction between the impedance and resistance over there. Okay, so this is the short introduction, and the formula for that one, actually, we have to take the triangle, impedance triangle we have to draw. Here it is there, I think. Somewhere it was there. Okay, next line is there. Okay, here, a practical circuit where both inductive reactance and capacitive reactance present along with resistance are either capacitance or capacitive reactance and inductive reactance present along with the resistance. Same thing two times again. There will be leading or lagging effect on the current of the circuit, depending on the value of reactance and resistance of the circuit here. Now, see here, if the, I am telling that one, if inductive Z equal to a combination of reactance and resistance, I told that one. If Z equal to R plus JX, I can write on here, JX. This X may be, if this X may be XL, this X may be XL, or it may be XC, or it may be XL minus XC, XL minus XC, or it may be XC minus XL. It may be XC minus XL here. See here, if the only inductive load is there, resistance and inductive is there, then the XL, we can recall that one here now. This reactance equal to XL here. Now, XL. XL is the inductive reactance. Whom XL equal to, what is the formula?
Omega.
Omega L here. Now, omega equal to 2 phi F. Omega equal to 2 phi F. We can call that one here. If only capacitance is there, then X equal to net reactance equal to capacitive reactance. We can call that one. X equal to XC. We can right here, no, only capacitive reactance is there, means XC equal to
1 upon 2 pi FC,
1 by omega C here, no, 1 by omega C, omega is nothing but 2 phi F, omega C we can call that. Suppose the reactance is combination of inductance and capacitance, and that situation we have to consider two things here. Now, if XL is greater than XC, then XL minus XC lignega. If XC is greater than XL, then XC minus XL, that is called X equal to, we can write that. We can write like that. Depending on combination of both are there, then X equal to XL minus XC for XL is greater than XC. If XC is greater than XL, then X equal to XC minus XL, we can write on here. So here the net reactance we have to write here. So in the AC circuit, The cumulative effect of reactance and resistance is termed as impedance here now. Reactance and resistance here now. Reactance and resistance only we have drawn here now. The impedance is normally denoted by English letter Z. Impedance is denoted by Z. The value of impedance is represented as here now. We can call this one here now. This is impedance triangle. We can call this one. This is Z. This is R. This is X. So X equal to Z equal to, we can write R square plus X square, square root of R square X square from the this impedance triangle. We can write like this. Z equal to square root of, actually the formula will come from here. Z square equal to R square plus X square. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Z square equal to R square plus X square. Then Z equal to square root of R square plus X square. We can write here now. We can write here now. So the R is nothing but resistance. X is nothing but the reactance here now. Okay. Samajh mein aa raha hai ya nahi? Impedance. Okay. The angle between the applied voltage and current is here now. From this one here, Z is there. Here R is there. This one X or this one X. Anything you can consider here now. Here X or this one R or this one R here. Here square box they have considered. This triangle you have considered means it is R, it is X. This triangle you have considered means it is X and it is R here now. So you know that one cos theta, sine theta, tan theta equal to what? Adjacent, opposite divided by adjacent divided by opposite. Malum hai ne? Mathematics you have studied on that.
Yes,
one. Tan theta yes, equal sir. To adjacent divided by opposite here now. Adjacent is nothing but which one? R here. This is adjacent, opposite, R. And this is hypotenuse. Yes. So R tan theta equal to R by X. So theta equal to tan inverse by R, tan inverse R by X. We can write down. Tan theta equal to R by X. So theta equal to tan inverse R by X. Yes. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So from this triangle, we have written theta is nothing but this is the angle here now. Phase angle we are going to call that one. Phase angle we are going to call that one. So the impedance can be represented in the complex form that one, Z equal to R plus JX in the complex form also. We can write here, this X is nothing but net reactance. It may be capacitive reactance, it may be inductive reactance, or it may be combination of capacitive and inductive reactance. We can call that one here. So this is the short introduction of the impedance here. If you have any doubts, you can ask now. Push doubt hai to push doubt before starting the AC bridges. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. So next I will go for AC bridges here. Now compare with the Wilson bridge. Just I will give this introduction. Bol ke chhod deta hu aaj. Just introduction I will tell that one. So here in the Wilson bridge, only it was R1 was there, R2 was there, R3 and R4 was there. Yes? R1, R2, R3, R4 was there. But here, the branch AB, it has resistance and inductance here. The resistance and inductance is there here?
Yes, sir.
Here the only resistance is there. Here the only resistance is there. But again, AD also, it has resistance and inductance here. Here, this branch also, it has resistance and inductance. This branch also, it has resistance and inductance. So in between these two, we have connected the detector we have connected here now. So this complete term of R1 and L1, it is called as Z1. We can call right this one. This one as Z1. Yes. This term, I can write as Z2. Can I write this one Z2? Yes, this R3 equal to Z3 we can write.
Yes, sir.
Because only R3 is there here. And R4 equal to? Z4. R4 equal to Z4. We already know the formula for the width and bridge, that is called R1 R4 equal to
R2 R3.
Okay, R2 R3, we know the formula here. So in this place, what we have to write? Z1 Z4 equal to Z2 Z3, we can write.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Z1 Z2 equal to Z2 Z3. We can write this one here. No, sorry, R likha hai. Z3 here now. But what do you mean by this? Z1 means what here now? Z1 equal to what?
R1
plus J XL, we have to write here now. X means omega L here now. Omega L1. J omega L1 we have to write on here. And here Z2 equal to
R2 plus J omega L2.
R2 plus J omega L2. J omega L2 we have to write down here. Then you substitute Z1 value here, Z4 value here, Z2 here, Z3 here now. And separate the real and imaginary terms here. In these two, which is the real term and which is imaginary term? This is the real and J term is imaginary term.
Yes.
So that we are going to discuss here now. I will take the next slide. That is, we have written here now. As an example, let us consider the AC bridge here now. Two inductances are present, that is L1 and L2 are inductances. So negligibly small resistance they have here now. So we know the formula from the Wilson bridge here now. From the Wilson bridge, we know Z1, Z4 equal to Z2, Z3. Okay. Z1 equal to R1 plus J omega L1. We have written here. Likha hai na? Z1 equal to R1 plus J omega L1. Z2 equal to R2 plus J omega L2. Z3 equal to R3 plus J0. There is no imaginary part. So only R3 is there. R3 I have written. Z4 equal to R4. Then what will happen? You substitute this Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 value in equation number 1. We will get R1 plus J omega L1 is Z1 here now. And Z4 equal to
R4.
R4 we have substituted. Equal to you have substituted. Z2 equal to
R2 plus
J omega L2. Next, Z3 equal to
R3
here now. Now you must split this term into here now. R1 into R4, that is R1 R4. I will write here now R1 R4. Next, plus symbol is there, plus symbol. J omega L1 into R4. J omega L1 into R4 I have written. Equal to term is there, equal to write on. R2 into R3. Plus symbol is there, plus. J omega L2 into R3. J omega L2 into R2 I have written. Now, important thing is here only. You have to separate the real term here now. What are the real terms are there here now? This is the real term. There is no imaginary term here now. Yes? The first one is real term. Next, which one is the real term? This is imaginary. This one is the real term.
R2, R3.
This two are the real terms here now. So R1, R4 equal to R2, R3. I can write like this.
Yes, sir.
R1, R4 equal to R2, R3. From this equation, we can find the resistance value.
Yes, sir.
Any value of any unknown resistance, we can find this one. Yes.
Yes, sir.
So, but our aim is to find resistance, inductance, capacitance. Capacitance is not there here. We'll find if the capacitance is there, we can get the formula. There is no capacity. Inductance formula we have to identify. So to identify the inductance formula, what you have to do? You make the imaginary part separate here. Now, this is the imaginary part. Here the imaginary part is there. J omega L1 into R4 equal to J omega L2 R3. I will write here J omega L1 R4 equal to J omega L2 R3. Here. From this equation, what I will do? I will cancel J omega get cancelled here now.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what is the term left here now? L1 R4 equal to?
L1 R4.
L2 R3.
L2 R3 here now. So L1 R3 R4. You can write any formula here now, L1 or L2 formula you can identify. Yes. So this is the equation for the finding the impedance of the bridge circuit here. Now we can find the resistance, impedance, capacitance also. Instead of using L1, if we have used C1 means we can find the C1 formula also we were getting over here. So this is the simple concept. If you know very, you know about the Wheatstone bridge means the next step will be very easy for all the things over there. We can call that one here. So from these two equations, next we will go for the I1 and R1 are the unknown quantities. I1, R1, they are telling that one, which are measured in terms of R2, R3, and L2 here now. Yes, starting me another equation. Okay, okay, leave that one. From R1 and L1 equation, what they are telling that one, the first equation is there, R1 equal to R2, R3 divided by R4 is there. Na? For that reason, R1, unknown quantities, which are measured in terms of R2, R3, and R4, and L2. From R1 and L1 quantities or equations, the following points are concluded here now. Two balance equation is always obtained from the AC bridges here now. How many equations we have obtained here now?
Two
equations. Two balance equations we have obtained here now. Second one, the unknown quantities are determined through the balanced equations here now. In these two equations, which one is unknown quantities, we can determine that one here now. The balance equations are independent of frequency. There is no frequency at all. Frequency cancel okay, omega omega.
Yes.
Okay. The AC bridges are also used in other applications like in the communication system, in complex electronic circuits and all the things we are going to use here now. So this is the simple general form of AC equations. The title only I have taken general form of the AC bridge here. Instead of this L1, I can use C1 here now. Here C use kar sakte kidhar to. We can use any combinations we can use. And based on that one, we have to use Z1, Z4 equal to Z2, Z3 formula use karne ka for balanced condition. And substitute the value of Z1, Z2, Z3, we have to substitute and you have to identify that. Okay, we'll stop here only. And in the tomorrow class, I will start the Maxwell bridges. Both the bridges will discuss that one. In the next class, we'll discuss the Maxwell bridge. Okay. I'll take the attendance just a minute. I have not marked your attendance. Roll number one.
Present, sir.
Two.
Present, sir.
Three. Four.
Present, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six.
Yes, sir.
Seven, eight, nine.
Yes, sir.
11. 11. Roll number 11. Absent. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
Yes, sir.
19, 20. 21, 22,
yes, sir.
23,
yes, sir.
24, 25,
present, sir.
26,
yes, sir.
27, 28, 29,
present, sir.
30, 31,
yes, sir.
32, 33.
Present, sir.
36. 36. 37, 38, 39, 40, 41.
Yes, sir.
42. 42.
Yes, sir.
43. 44.
Present, sir.
Okay. The roll numbers, not absent roll numbers, I will tell that one. If your number is there, you can tell me. Roll number 3 is absent. Roll number 11, 13, 14, 15. 14 present again?
Yes, sir.
15, 16, 19, 20, 21, 24.
21 present.
20 is present.
21 present, sir.
21 present, okay. 24, 27, 28, 30, 32, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 43. Okay. So we'll stop here only, and one more instruction I want to give you people. Your CyberArm account password, username, password, mere paas hai. कोई भी कॉलेज में आए तो मेरे को मिलके जाओ कंप्यूटर कम टू कंप्यूटर लैब एंड यू कैन कलेक्ट योर CyberArm आईडी यूजर नेम एंड पासवर्ड यू कैन कलेक्ट फॉर द इंटरनेट यूजर नेम आईडी इट इज देयर विद सम पीपल्स यू आस्क्ड मी बाय विजिटिंग द क्लास यू हैव आस्क्ड दैट वन यू कैन कम एंड कलेक्ट फ्रॉम मी द लेबोरेटरी एंड वन मोर थिंग योर ISC मार्क्स आर ऑल्सो इवेल्युएटेड So some people, so many things you are missing. It is actually, I'm disappointed from your answer. Some people, especially boys' side, by sitting in your house, it is an open book. All the material is available with you. Then also you have skipped the questions. Writing is skipped. And some people, you have written only one line answer. It is not good, actually good thing. You have to improve a lot. It will affect to your academics only. It will not affect to us. Your academics means one marks is very important now. So many people, they will failed because of one marks also. You don't know the value of one marks. In that situation, out any two questions you have to write in each out of three, some people, they have written only one question. I don't know what was the problem with, of that person's. Some people, they have skipped. Some people without diagram, only one line answers they have written. I will show all the subject ISC marks, maybe in the Wednesday proctor session, we'll discuss that one. Okay. Anything else you want to discuss, you can ask. Rule number 9. Have you sent the answer sheet?
Yes, sir. Kian.
I have not seen that one. We'll check that one. Okay, कोई किसी को कुछ पूछना है तो पूछ सकते हैं. And one more thing, all of you use the official mail ID use करो, college mail ID use करो, उसको activate करो, and your mobile थोड़ा login करके रखो. Next your placement activities will start. So everything will come on official mail ID only. No, we are not going to consider the personal mail ID. Remember that thing also. Okay. And one more thing, I will stop here only regarding that activity. And okay, we'll stop here only and we'll continue in the next class. You finish that NSS activities. And one more thing regarding the COVID vaccination, all of you take the vaccination as early as possible, because in the news again they are telling that when the Omicron is spreading like anything. So take care of yourself and care of others also. You have to take care of others also. Take your vaccination first. Thank you.